Hello people, in this video we want to look at Bucheraria bancrofti, okay? So basically what is Bucheraria bancrofti? It is this worm, right? It is a nematode. It is a helminth, a nematode. It is a filarial worm, okay? It causes filariasis. In the extreme form, this will be called as elephantiasis, where you can see this kind of non-pitting type of edema will be present. You can see this is elephantiasis, right? This is also called as Malabar leg, okay? So basically people who live by the river, by the sea, they are prone to getting this infection of Bucheraria bancrofti, okay? So basically we are studying parasitology. This is going to be a parasite, right? Parasitology. We are reading parasites, about parasites. So basically Bucheraria bancrofti, did you get an idea what it is? It is a helminth nematode filarial worm that causes this disease, filariasis, elephantiasis, occult filariasis, a lot of things, okay? So we will try to explain the entire thing about Bucheraria bancrofti using this diagram, okay? So basically you can see here, there is a line here in the middle. This side whatever is representing, this is the mosquito part, and here you have the man part, okay? So basically for Bucheraria bancrofti in the life cycle, you can see the definitive host is man and the intermediate host is the Culex mosquito. Okay, so did you understand this much? The definitive host is man. Here the multiplication is happening, right? So basically definitive host is man and the intermediate host is going to be a mosquito. Which mosquito? Culex mosquito. This Culex, now very specifically they have mentioned Culex fatigans, okay? So let's start off with the man getting the infection. So look at this man here. See, he got bit by an infected mosquito, a Culex mosquito. This is Indian scenario. The Culex mosquito bit him. So this Culex mosquito in the proboscis, it had the third stage filariform larva, which is actively motile. This is the infective form of Bucheraria bancrofti. Which is the infective form? The third stage filariform larva, which is actively motile. You can see it's quite a big larva and it will be present in the mosquito's proboscis. A lot of them have to be present actually to infect man, and it is going to penetrate the skin, right? Here we will destroy some of the larva ourselves, but some of them do make it to the lymph nodes. So did you understand here? So the third stage infective filariform larva, which is actively motile, from the proboscis of the Culex mosquito which has bitten this man, now it enters, okay, whatever got destroyed from our immune system got destroyed, but the remaining, they will come and enter the lymph nodes. What are they attacking? The lymph nodes, okay. Now pay attention here. In the lymph node, what will happen? This third stage filariform larva, they will become adult worms. They will sexually mature in 6 months and they will start multiplying. So 6 months it is staying there, it is developing into adult worm. Okay. Then they will start multiplying. Once they start multiplying, here these are viviparous. They are going to lay microfilariae, no eggs here. Please pay attention here. There are no eggs here. It is going to lay what is called as microfilariae. Okay. So these Bucheraria bancrofti are what? They are viviparous. So where this microfilaria will be, they will be there in the lymph. Okay. They will be in the lymph. Okay. So this microfilaria itself, the structure is so very interesting, right? This is a sheath. This black color, what you see is a sheath. Inside it, you have the larva. Okay. So this, now what happens? If you want, we can explain the structure of this microfilaria also. How to distinguish the microfilaria of the Bucheraria bancrofti from the microfilaria of the other worms. This is also important. We'll come to that. As of now, let's not get deviated with the structure of microfilaria. Let's move on now. Now what happens? Where is it? It's in the lymph. No, so obviously it will drain, let us say, into the thoracic duct, and then it will enter the blood. Okay. And that too, when it will enter the blood, you know, only when the person sleeps. More than saying nocturnal, only when the person sleeps, it will enter the blood, right? And when this mosquito bites this person, if it bites in the night or when he's sleeping, that time this mosquito picks up these microfilariae. Notice here that the microfilariae, they can't do anything until it reaches the mosquito. They just can't do anything in the human beings. They just stay as microfilariae and then they die. But only if they want to become something, they have to enter the mosquito, okay? How is it going so far, guys? Did you understand what is happening? We finished the man part. The mosquito bit the man. Then what happened? The mosquito bit the man. From there to lymph node, there adult worms you got. Then these multiplied. They gave the microfilaria. So microfilaria will actually be inside a sheath. They will be inside the sheath like this, right? These microfilaria, they will just stay in the lymph. Only when it is night or when the person is sleeping, they will come to the blood. Otherwise, they won't come to the blood. They will be there only. So in the blood, there will be there. This is RBC we have tried to draw. In between, we are showing you these microfilaria. Only in the night or in the when the person sleeps, they come to the blood. And now what happens here, a new mosquito has to come and bite this man. Okay. So that time from the blood means this mosquito can pick up the microfilaria. So far, so good. Man part is done. Okay. In man itself, the multiplication, reproduction, all these progeny, everything has been made in man. Okay. Now this microfilaria has to go mature and come back. Okay. Let's see how it is happening. So now let us see what happens in the mosquito. So have you seen so far that what happens in the man? Man we have covered. Now we are moving on to the mosquito, which is an intermediate host. That's the Culex mosquito. Now look at this here. We'll try to zoom in here. It enters the mosquito. So the mosquito is biting the man here. Let's take a different color for mosquito. Which color shall we take for mosquito? Which color is mosquito? Gray? Let's take a gray or a black? Black. Okay. So this mosquito is biting this man. This man is now infected, right? Now what this mosquito will do? It will pick up these microfilaria. These microfilaria, once they get picked up, they will exsheath. They'll come out of their sheath. In the stomach of the mosquito, it will penetrate the stomach of the mosquito. Can you see? There is a larva coming out here. Wait, let's zoom. So we have zoomed here. Hope you can see now. So basically, this mosquito is biting this man and mosquito is picking up the microfilaria, right? Now, in the mosquito, the exsheathing of this filarial microfilaria happens, okay? So it will exsheath. Then, what has come out, that is in the stomach of the mosquito, it will penetrate the stomach of the mosquito and it will reach the muscle, thoracic muscle it will reach. How much of you are clear about what is happening in the mosquito? Is it difficult to understand? So basically in the mosquito, if this microfilaria will exsheath, it will penetrate the wall of the mosquito and reach the thoracic muscles. That's all. Then, now look at what has happened. So here, once it has reached the thoracic muscle of the mosquito, then first stage larva, second stage larva, third stage infective form larva. That's all. So it's very easy here. Then it becomes the infective form again in the mosquito. That's all. So infective form is active. Actively motile, it is third stage filariform larva, which is the infective form for man. And after this, the entire cycle will continue. That's all, guys. This is Bucheraria bancrofti. So in man, what and all it will cause? In man, what and all it will cause? You know, it will cause filariasis. In filariasis itself, there are two types of filariasis. There is classic filariasis and occult filariasis. Classic filariasis means where the lymph etc. are affected. Here in occult filariasis, there's actually hypersensitivity to the antigen of these worms. Okay. So guys, look at what exactly are the clinical manifestations. There can be classic filariasis and occult filariasis. Under classic filariasis, basically you will see acute adeno-lymph angitis. Okay. So here this is characterized by lymph angitis, lymph adenitis, lymph edema, lymph angiovarix. Okay. So the lymph, everything lymph is affected. Okay. So lymph angitis, like inflamed lymph vessels. So the lymph vessels, let's say this is a lymph vessel. Let's take a purple here. Lymph. So lymph vessels are inflamed, right? This lymph angitis. Then inflammation of lymph node will be lymph adenitis. Lymph node will be inflamed means lymph adenitis. Lymph edema means what? Swellings, right? Basically swellings. So there will be, initially it will be pitting type of edema. Then there will be non-pitting edema. Then lymph angiovarix means dilatation of these lymph vessels. Okay. So that is lymph angiovarix. All these will happen. in classic filariasis. Also, there can be hydrocele. Hydrocele means the lymph vessels to the spermatic cord are obstructed, so there will be exudation from the inflamed testis and epididymis. Okay. What is lymphorrhagia? So, leaking lymph is lymphorrhagia. Okay. So, basically, let us say from this lymph vessel, all the lymph is leaking. It can be either seen in the urine or it can be seen as diarrhea. So, there can be chylous diarrhea or chylous urine. So, everywhere there is lymph. Okay. Finally, they are talking about elephantiasis. So, basically, it is a last thing that they are mentioning is elephantiasis. This is a delayed sequel to repeated lymphangitis, obstruction, lymphedema. This is non-pitting edema. You can see here, elephantiasis, right? The swelling in the leg, etc. Probably the name is because it's like an elephant's leg or it is so swollen, it is so big, right? So lastly, we will move on to occult filariasis. What is occult filariasis? Because here in occult filariasis, basically there is a reaction, a hypersensitivity reaction to the antigens which these worms carry. Right here, they are not talking about the lymph obstruction by these worms or something like that. This is hypersensitivity to the antigens of these worms, okay? Main thing that there will be there in this is the eosinophilia. So, eosinophils will be more. Eosinophilia will be there. IgE, it's an allergic reaction, so hypersensitivity reaction. So, IgE, asthmatic cough, right? All these are standard things that you will write. Asthmatic wheezing, cough, dyspnea, right? Standard things that you will write with any allergic reaction, okay? So, the lymphatic filariasis are absent. So, classic features of this lymphatic filariasis are absent. Classic features are absent. Guys, we have to also cover the treatment, right? Treatment is what? DEC, diethyl, what is this? Diethyl carbamazine citrate, right? This is the drug of choice for filariasis. Diethyl carbamazine citrate. DEC is the drug of choice for filariasis, remember? We still have a lot to cover, like the lab diagnosis we have to cover, guys. Lab diagnosis and structure of microfilaria also we want to cover, what microfilarias are and how they are different in different worms. So those are all very specific to microbiology. You can come back for those videos. What you have seen in this video is very generic. Buchereria, Bancrofti, the life cycle, things like the pathogenesis, etc. So come back for the next video. We will look at this microfilaria of Bancrofti, the structure, etc. Okay. That's all for now, guys. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.